Hey guys, what's going on? Chris here with Shughead Gaming, with another episode in my series aimed at covering peripherals and quality of life products coming out for the VR scene. My hope is to bring you honest and detailed information along with my first-hand impressions to not only inform you of interesting VR-related products across all VR platforms, but most importantly, to let you know if it's worth picking up. Let's get into it. Do you wear glasses and play VR? If you do, then like me, you're probably tired of worrying about scratching both your headset lenses and your glasses, or simply irritated with how clunky the whole process can be, with glasses getting stuck inside face covers that aren't wide enough, or in the case of the PSVR, losing precious field of view by not being able to pull it right tight to your face, hence giving you more of that goggle effect that just kills the immersion. So, if any of that sounds familiar, stick around because today I am taking a look at prescription lenses from VR Wave, which are lens inserts that are made to match the exact prescription of your regular glasses, meaning you no longer have to bother with glasses when throwing on your headset or jam contact lenses in your eyeballs just to play VR unhindered. Yeah, I did that too. Consequently, I have been meaning to review these for at least the last 7 months, but game reviews have kept me from being able to get this review done. But as a result, I have had 7 months of use with them, and I can tell you, despite one issue that I'll get into, I will never, ever wear glasses in VR again. Now, my review lenses were for the Quest 2, but for those wondering about different headsets, VR Wave does make lenses for the original Quest, Rift S, Valve Index, HP Reverb 2, PSVR, and the full suite of HTC Vive headsets. In addition, for those interested, you can also have included on your lenses an anti-glare filter and a blue light filter to further improve the image quality of your headset. First thing I noticed when I received my lenses was that they felt like a quality item and not something that was just 3D printed and rushed out the door. Coming in a slick, hard shell travel case, the single pair of lenses and two pairs of magnetic bases felt like they actually came from my optician. Simply remove your facial interface from your headset to clearly expose your lenses, remove any spacers you may already have on the lenses, and then carefully install the magnetic base clip that matches the proper eye, an important aspect since each eye is custom made as per your prescription. Once installed properly, magnets facing up, these base clips should click into place and not move under any normal down pressure. Now, what I loved about this design is all I had to do was simply clip on the prescription lenses and replace my facial interface, and I was good to go. However, if I'm sharing the headset around, which is one of my favorite things to do, I can simply pull off the lenses, leaving only the bases on, and pass the headset on to a normie without any of the "how do you see through these" comments. Remember to clean them periodically with the provided microfiber cloth, and that should be it for maintenance. Now, onto my one gripe. Once installed, the lenses do come out a bit more off the lenses than I would have liked. Though, due to the rounded nature of the lenses, I get it. As such, with my Quest 2, using the standard Oculus interface and the included spacer, I had no issues. However, I had upgraded to the VR Cover facial interface, and it wasn't compatible with the spacer that Oculus provides. The resulting fit meant I could feel the VR lenses pressing lightly against the brow of my forehead. Now, a little adjustment, and this wasn't too much of an issue, but I can still feel them pushing a little bit when I would look up at things. Alternatively, I've also heard of people's noses feeling pinched, though the new VR cover with the nose guard seems to mitigate that issue, as does the facial interface actually made by VR cover, something which I haven't tried and may actually fix my issue as well. Regardless, keep in mind, results may vary depending on the headset, the shape of your face, and the facial interface you are using. And that brings me to my final review. Despite my own issues with the final fit and the fact that results may vary on your setup, I would say this is an awesome solution for my fellow four-eyed friends, as my prescription lenses by VR Wave are now a mandatory accessory for any headset that I use, as it just makes putting on, taking off, and especially just using my headset so much less of a hassle, which prior to was honestly a reason that I would use to just not play VR sometimes. In addition, it also removed any field of view limitations that I had had due to either my own glasses or any additional measures that I'd taken to get space between my glasses and the headset lenses. I was impressed with the quality, and the pricing I think is actually incredibly fair, coming in at a base price of $30 US. And as I mentioned, you can choose to add on an anti-glare and or blue light filter, which will run you an additional $15 each. Neither of which you need, and simply improve your base headset experience. And finally, shipping, which depending on where you live and how fast you want them, could cost you an additional $8 to $18, so you could be looking at about $50 to $75 in. Honestly, a far cry from the $185 I paid this summer for my prescription sunglasses. So if you're interested, guys, get a hold of your most recent prescription info and head on over to VRWave's website, which I will put into the notes below. And for stopping by and watching my review, guys, I have a promo code that you guys can use to get 5% off on your next purchase. Simply add in Shughead when you're checking out. Well, guys, that'll be it for me. Thanks for stopping by. Please hit that like button if you so choose. And if you're interested in supporting the channel further, you can do so through Patreon or, you know, simply sharing this video. Anyways, guys, I'll catch you on my next video.